Welcome to this Tutor to You topic video that looks at sustainable energy. This is part of Paper 2, Unit C, The Challenge of Resource Management. For an energy supply to be sustainable, it needs to meet the needs of today's population without harming the ability of future generations to meet their own energy needs. This becomes increasingly challenging as global population growth and economic development drive up the demand for fuel. Sustainable energy has three principles at heart. Firstly, ensuring that carbon emissions are significantly lowered in order to fight climate change, which means reducing our reliance on fossil fuels. Secondly, developing alternative sources of energy and making renewable technology more efficient so renewable energy can become more reliable and generate power on a larger scale. Thirdly, increasing energy efficiency through developing technology that needs less energy, but also stopping energy wastage, which is known as energy conservation. There are lots of ways that we can conserve energy. The first thing that we're going to look at is our personal energy use. So we can conserve energy personally by not leaving appliances on standby and not leaving phones, tablets, laptops, etc. charging overnight. We also need to use energy efficient appliances such as washing machines that don't need to be heated so much and low energy light bulbs. We should only use dishwashers and washing machines when they are fully loaded. We could choose to wear extra layers of clothing in the winter so we don't need to heat the house quite so much. We can also close blinds and curtains to trap in heat in the winter, which will reduce the need for central heating, and cool the house in the summer to reduce the need for electric fans or air conditioning units. And obviously, we can reduce car use by walking and cycling on short journeys. But let's have a think about how building design can help us to conserve energy. We should have much more efficient central heating systems. Old gas boilers are not particularly efficient and they use a lot of energy to heat homes, so they should be replaced by condensing boilers, which are much more efficient. Many homes are now using ground source heat pumps, which use less energy as they recover a lot of heat. We can also make use of small scale renewable energy, for example, installing solar panels on the roof, or small wind turbines that can be used to generate electricity and heat water. But much more common are the following options available to us. We can have double or triple glazed windows. Heat is lost through windows, so the better the glazing, the less energy is lost, which will have an impact on heating bills. We need to think about insulation. Heat rises to the top of the house, and it's always warm up there. However, heat is also lost through poorly insulated roof spaces, so homes need to have proper loft insulation. Modern homes are often built with cavity walls which are hollow. It is very quick and easy to insulate this space to reduce heat loss. However, older homes tend to have solid walls, so insulation has to be put on the inside or the outside of the walls. Proper insulation throughout will reduce heat loss and will help to lower energy bills. Finally, we need to think about reducing drafts. Old houses are full of drafts, particularly through fireplaces and big gaps in floorboards. But heat also escapes through the gaps around doors and windows, so these need to be sealed up to prevent heat loss. On the screen, you have a thermal image which shows just how much heat is lost through poor insulation. There are also lots of ways to conserve energy in the workplace and in schools. Setting the thermostat to 19 degrees or less. Offices and classrooms are full of people, therefore they don't need to be heated any more than this. Leaving doors and windows shut when heating or air conditioning systems are working. This also means that energy is not wasted heating or cooling places that don't need it, such as storerooms. Switching off computers and printers properly at the end of the day. But also not leaving these on charge all day as they don't need 8 hours of charging. Keeping blinds open to reduce the need for artificial light, which is better for workers and students than fluorescent strip lights. And finally, using energy efficient lighting and ensuring that lighting is not left on when rooms are empty. You can also have lights activated by movement that will help with this. We're going to finish off this video thinking about how we can reduce the energy needed for transport. One way would be to improve public transport systems and reduce travel costs to encourage people to use their cars less. We could also reduce car use by providing safer cycle path networks to encourage people to use their bikes more. We could invest in more cycle hire schemes like the Santander bikes in London so people can hire bikes for short periods. Car share schemes would reduce the number of cars on the road, particularly during rush hour. We also need further investment into electric vehicles, better charging networks, larger mileage range, more efficient batteries, all sorts. We also need to reduce the cost of electric and hybrid cars compared to petrol and diesel cars. And finally, reducing air travel, particularly domestic flights where train travel is an option, would have a huge impact on the demand for energy needed for transport. That concludes this Tutor to You topic video focusing on sustainable energy. Thank you for watching.